Hey guys! Thank you for tuning in again this week. I am sorry I missed last week. my life has been hellacious the past like 2 weeks. But for today's video, it's kind of going to be like a double whammy. I'm going to do a face mask because I have not been eating right at all, and my face feels disgusting. I feel grittiness on it. It's not fun. And I'm also going to do a lip plumper, which I don't know if anybody's seen it. I haven't really seen it, like any other YouTubers or like anybody on Instagram use it. But I did come across this company. And it's, okay, so I'm just gonna show it to you. But it's like these little weird lip thingies. And they look really weird, but they just go on your lips like this. And so I wanna put the mask on first and then put this on. And yeah, I'm just gonna rejuvenate myself because I have been very stressed out the last couple weeks. So it's gonna be like a little mini spa day. Hey, girls' night on a Tuesday. Let's go ahead and get started into my impression of these so far. First, that they look really silly, of course, and I just feel like I may not be able to talk with them, and that was the plan, was to do the mask and then put this on and then tell you all about my weeks. Since this has to sit on, or at least the mask has to sit on for about 15 minutes. But these don't come with any instructions. It literally came in this, and that was it. There's nothing else. So doesn't really give you much info, and I didn't do any research, so why not? But let's get started with the mask. I do this mask a lot. I used to work at an Aveda salon back home in Kentucky. This was a very common mask that we would use in the spa. It's two different products mixed together. So yeah, I'll get more into that in a little bit. But first, I have already washed my face. I didn't want to use my Clarisonic, which is what I normally do, because this mask is going to have an exfoliator in it, so I didn't want to over-exfoliate. So I've already washed my skin. The only thing I have on is mascara. And the first thing I'm going to do is use this Paul Mitchell Awakui Moisture Mist. This is just a hydrating spray, so I'm just going to use it to rehydrate my skin, kind of open up the pores a little bit since it's been about 10 minutes or so since I washed my face. So here we go. So the main product that I'm going to use in the mask is an Aveda. It's for their, like, it's like their acne line. It's called Outer Peace. This is a green mask and it's a cooling mask. So that is gonna help. I don't know if you've all ever noticed, but right here on my cheeks, I kind of get a little bit of redness. So this is supposed to help reduce that. It calms your skin, it, like, balances the pH. Yeah, reduces redness. So that's gonna be the biggest part of this. And then the exfoliating aspect is gonna be the tourmaline charged. I love this stuff. We used to do manicures and use this on the tops of the hands to exfoliate the hands. Oh, look, there's Zoe. That's my little puppy girl. And a little baby girl. And a little baby girl. And here's Bailey, he's jealous. Aw, hi. My little babies. But this is a skin refiner. It is made from like microscopic seashells, which is really cool. It's a neutral exfoliating cream, refines skin texture for renewed radiance. It has been said that if you use this like twice a week for 6 weeks, it's supposed to be the equivalent of microdermabrasion. I do not use this that much, so I don't know, I can't hold true to that, but that was just something that, like, when we did classes that's kind of what we were told, and that was like a cool selling point, if you will. So yeah, I have the two in this cute little bowl, and I'm just gonna mix them together and apply to my skin. All right, we are nice and green. One thing I do love about this mask is the fact that it's cold. I just like the way it feels refreshing. It's like cold and chilly, and I'm always hot anyways, so I like this mask, and I like the exfoliating factors in it because it's not too harsh. Now, let's move on to this. I'm gonna take a few selfies first. So. So now that that's done, let's put this on my lips. Shall we? Ooh. Oh. Well, that's odd. I think it's supposed to, like, all the juices. It's like a little tray. I think all the juices are supposed to. Oh. Yes. Oh. Before we go any further, because I forgot to do this, let's do a before. So now that we got a close-up of the before of my lips, let's put this on. I'm kind of nervous. Okay. So I think my camera malfunctioned a little bit. So I don't know how much you all got of that. I haven't looked. I think this is going to be really difficult to talk with. So I'm going to move this up a wee bit. Ugh. Okay, so it's not sticking very well onto my face. I feel very weird. But I think that's because of my own stupidity. I didn't think about the face mask going so close to my mouth and this being so big. I legit feel like a dinosaur right now. Like, I don't know, I feel like I could be some like hot fashion diva dinosaur. Anyways, while this sits on, I just need to vent about the last few weeks of my life. And this is going to be a long story, and I'm sorry. I'm going to try to brief as much as possible. Okay, so let's start with Saturday. I don't even know the date, but it was in the beginning of February. A really good friend of mine, we grew up together essentially, and she moved out here to LA when we were like 8, and we have always stayed in touch. I do consider, like, no matter how many fights we get in, I do still consider her one of my best friends. So we hadn't talked, like, we had gotten into an argument and we hadn't talked in like 2 months. And she messages me one night at like 11:30 at night, and she was like, "Hey, are you up?" I said, "No." Well, I didn't say no. I replied the next morning and I was like, "I'm up now. What's up?" And she said, like, Nana died, which is her grandmother who helped raise me essentially. Like, she lived down at the lake back home in Kentucky, and Dusty and I would go there all the time, and we would hang out with Nanny. We'd go down the boat, we'd go fishing. She, like, for the first time ever, I had gone and visited her with one of my boyfriends at the time, and she made us breakfast, and she made me chorizo eggs, and I was like, what the hell is chorizo? I don't even know what that is. What kind of, like, what animal is it? Didn't know anything about it. And so, like, that's one memory I always have of her. And green beans, we would always used to, like, clean green, like, fresh from the garden green beans that she grew. And so I got the news on a Saturday, like, it was like two or three Saturdays ago, that she had passed. Which, good thing that came out, that is Destiny and I have made amends, and we are now all friends again, which is awesome. So that was Saturday, and then that following Thursday, like, one of my very first friends that I had ever made in LA, her and I got into an argument, and, like, I initiated the argument. I know that. But I kind of thought it was one of those things where I was, like, I was upset with her, and I felt that I needed to express those feelings and just be done with it. Like, I expressed the feelings, we hashed it out, we're done, everything's back to normal, and then she terminated our friendship, which took a pretty big hit, like, especially after finding out that, you know, Nanny had died. And then that was Thursday, and then that following Saturday, ugh, this keeps going in my mouth. And then that following Saturday, so a week after Nanny died, I got word that one of my really good friends back home in Kentucky had passed away in a car accident. And obviously that is hard, you know, when, you know, someone is so young and it, you know, wasn't meant to be, like, it wasn't their time to go. Like, it's always hard to deal with. So that one hit me really hard, and I was on set when I got the news of that, and I was trying to hold it together, and I just couldn't. And then that Monday morning, I left. Luckily, there's a guy that lives out in LA that is friends with the same group of people that I would, like, that I'm friends with. He knew the girl that had passed away as well, and so luckily, I asked him if he would want to drive, because plane tickets were so expensive. Plane tickets were like $700 to $900. So I asked him if he would want to drive with me, because I had a Prius, and you know, Priuses get really good gas mileage. I was like, it would maybe cost us $300 round trip, and then if we split that, that's $150. Like, you know, it takes a lot longer, but it saves us money. And so I ended up doing that and drove back home. We left LA. It was 6:30 a.m. LA time, which is 9:30 a.m. Louisville time. And then we got to Louisville at like 4:30 in the afternoon on Tuesday afternoon. So it's like a 31-hour drive. So I think it's a 30-hour drive if you just don't ever stop according to like GPS. It's 2,100 miles. So that's that. And that was atrocious. I mean, it was fun, but I've done that drive by myself before, and with just my dogs and me, and it was miserable. So it was nice to have someone there to, like, switch off driving. I felt a lot safer. So I spend my week-ish, like, 5 days in Kentucky, you know, go to the visitation, go to the funeral, go to the burial. You know, it was nice to see everyone, but, you know, that's always a hard situation, and it's never fun to, like, be like, oh yeah, let's hang out because of the death. And, like, you realize how close friendships are when you lose someone so close to you. So that's a shitty situation. And then my car, I don't know what happened to it. So, like, a long time ago, there was an issue where, like, my alarm system kept, like, just randomly going off. Hold on a second, that's my mom. Hello?
Hello?
Okay, where was I? So, my car. So, this was months ago. This was, like, back when Pokemon Go was a big thing. Because my roommate and I had drove down to Santa Monica Pier, because there was a specific Pokemon that apparently was, like, very active in that area. So, we drove, like, 45 minutes to go to Santa Monica Pier to get this Pokemon. And I just remember our meter was running out. And I had driven, and once I got into range to put more money into the meter, the alarm started going off, and I was like, oh, that's weird. I didn't even know I had an alarm system on this car because it's old. It was 2005, and I was like, I don't know, like, I just didn't think I had one or that it worked. And so it kept happening. Like, I would, you know, unlock and lock my car back with the fob, and then I would walk away, and once I got out, like, past like 6 feet away from the car, it would go off again. It was so weird. And so I didn't think anything of it. I was like, oh, it's just a weird glitch, I don't know, like, maybe I hit the panic button on my thing, because my key fob was like super messed up, and like the rubber, like, that covered the keys was peeling backwards. And so I was like, maybe the panic button is just stuck, I don't know. So a few weeks pass, and it keeps happening consistently. And so, whatever, you know, I just don't even think about it. It keeps happening. I go to Toyota, and I, like, tell them that I'm getting ready to drive to Kentucky. This is in August that I finally went. So I went to Toyota, and I was like, hey, you know, this keeps happening, and that's not normal. And I was like, I'm getting ready to drive to Kentucky, and I just don't want this, for some reason, to malfunction and, like, screw up my entire car. And they were like, okay, well, you know, just bring it in. We'll give you a new fob and, like, change over the computer system and all of that. But he was like, if it keeps happening, let us know. It's probably a bigger issue than just your fob not being perfect. I forgot that entire sentence that he had said until I was in Kentucky this past time, like a week ago, not even 2 days ago. And so, lolly lolly, I go to Kentucky back in August, I get back, I drive there. Eventually, what had happened was, like, a water pump messed up and a coolant valve messed up in my car. And the weird thing was, is that the water pump had just been replaced by the previous owner back in 2013. And so, again, that didn't raise a flag until after all of this other stuff started happening while driving to Kentucky last week. And so, you know, whatever, it happens. Like, driving to Kentucky, you know, it's mountains, and there was, like, one part where the battery, the hybrid battery, wasn't holding a charge, and then it wasn't allowing us to accelerate past a certain speed, especially on an incline. And so, you know, we pull over, we get gas, and he was like, you know what, let's check your oil just in case. My oil was completely bare. We left on Monday the 13th. Yes, it was Monday the 13th. I had just gotten an oil change on, like, January 19th or 18th or something like that. So they should have detected if there was a leak or if there was anything wrong. Like, I just, and that's never happened in this car. Like, I've never, like, had someone tell me when I got an oil change, like, oh, you had, like, no oil in there at all. Like, that's not good. So that, again, was just kind of, like, obnoxious. I didn't really think anything of it. The guy who was with me, he's actually worked on cars before, and he said that I had, like, a crack somewhere, and it was essentially leaking coolant from the coolant reservoir to my oil, which is not good. So that's a fun fact. So whatever, we get to Kentucky. My dad looks at it. He says that there's, like, nothing wrong with it. At that point, it was driving fine once I had actually gotten into Kentucky and the roads were a little bit more steady. And so he said nothing was wrong with it. I went and got an oil change once I was in Kentucky. They couldn't find a leak or anything. So that was weird. And then once we, actually, I went to my friend's house and her roommate came home. And this guy hit my car. As if it wasn't, like, already, like, going back to Kentucky was already, like, such a disaster to begin with. Like, he hits my car and I'm just like, perfect. Like, I work for Uber. Like, if I hadn't have already gotten my yearly inspection, like, they would not approve me to work this year with that big old dent in my car. Like, which, granted, luckily it was just a dent on my bumper, so it was a super easy fix. Like, he didn't break anything, like a headlight or anything like that, but still, it was just like the icing on the cake, and it was like the day before I left. So we start driving back to LA and the same thing happens. Like, I had just put oil in it. I had just gotten an oil change on Saturday. And then halfway through our trip, there's no oil. We stopped every like 2 hours. And every stop I would check the oil to make sure there was oil in it. So between stop 3 and stop 4, or whatever stops it was, oil just magically disappears. And I was like, okay, this is not normal. This is whatever. So at that point I decide, done with the car. There's something wrong with it. I feel like there was a computer issue that was making all these things malfunction, because the oil change that I had gotten back in January, once I got my car back, my passenger window, you could roll it down, but you couldn't roll it back up on your own. Like, I had to roll up the passenger's front window for them. Not a big deal, it's just electrical, you know, fine, brush it off. On the way back from Kentucky to LA, all of that changes. Out of nowhere, we're able to roll up the window again. And I'm like, oh, cool, like it just fixed itself, amazing. Little did we know, the next time we stopped, when, like, so normally with the key fob, it's a keyless car. So typically, like, as long as I had the fob in range of my car, I could either put my hand on the handle, like, bar to, like, let you into the car, put my hand in it, and as soon as I put my hand in the sensor, it would unlock the car. Or there's a button on it, and once you get out of the car, you push this little button on the handle, and it locks the car. And then to start it, you just have to have your key in the car somewhere, like near the engine, and you just push the button and it starts. So as soon as the window started to work again, we found out that the fob, like, doesn't work at all. Like, it won't unlock or lock the car, like, without, like, I could use it to actually push the button on the fob, but normally you wouldn't have to do that. And then in the car to actually make it start, then once the window started working, I had to insert the fob on my keychain into this little, like, where it goes in case the battery dies. And it was just the oddest thing. And like the hybrid battery wasn't holding a charge. Like, if we were going downhill, it would charge the battery. But then, like, as soon as we started accelerating again, it would just go back down to one thing. And like, we couldn't use cruise control. It was just a mess. And so finally, once I got to LA, I was like, I'm washing my hands of this car. Something is about to break and I'm gonna have to invest another, like, I don't know, $1,000, $2,000 into fixing, and the car's not even worth it. Oh! So, back in November, I bought 4 brand new tires for this car, and after dropping off my friend at his place, I head to my place, and I'm on the 101 in traffic, and my tire just pops out of nowhere. And so I call the place where I bought these tires and I was like, hey, it's been 4 months. That's not normal. Is there any sort of warranty? And he was like, well, if it was a road hazard, no. But if it's a faulty tire, then yes. And I'm like, okay, so what do I do? He was like, oh, just bring it in. and then we'll look at it. And I'm like, okay. So I don't have a tire. I barely have a functional working, like, donut tire to put on my car. I've been in the car for 33 hours driving across the country. I haven't showered in like 3 days almost, it seems like. I hadn't brushed my teeth that day. And this guy wants me to come put a tire in my car and bring it to him so he can look at it, so for him to tell me that it was a road hazard. Because you know that's what they do. They don't want to admit that it was a faulty tire. So I'm going to take this off, you know, and I'm going to finish this story, and then I'm going to take a shower and finish my last reviews, okay? Ew, it like rips really easy. Let's take a look. I don't know if I noticed a real big difference. Feels really tingly. I'll take some photos of afterwards. But back to the story. So I take it to the place where I got the tires. They were like, oh yeah, it was a road hazard. And I'm like, okay, well, if it was a road hazard because I wasn't changing lanes, when it actually popped, ooh, it really tingles now. why didn't my front tire pop as well? And he was like, well, I don't know. And I'm like, of course. And like, where it was like a slash in my tire, and where it was like in the, like the rivets of the tire. So like, you know when people say to check your tires, you stick your penny or stick a coin or whatever and see how like deep it is? It was like in that, like where the penny would go. And I'm like, that doesn't make sense that something would slash that. Like normally it's like not in the rivets, it's on the raised part that like gives you the friction, I guess. I don't know, it was just weird. And I was like, fuck it. Like at this point, I am going to CarMax. I don't care what they offer me, I am selling this car. And that's exactly what I did. So I sold my car yesterday. And so now, this morning, I went and bought a bike, and I don't have a car, which is really weird. It's just been a mess. My life has been such a mess. Oh, and I worked for Uber. That was like my main source of income when I wasn't on set. So I sold my car, and I don't have a job anymore, technically. I mean, yeah, freelance makeup, but that's not an everyday thing. So that is my story for right now, and life is so much fun. And it sucks because, like, you know, it's very easy to slip into this negative state of mind when crap like this happens to you. But one thing that I like is very, very evident in this world, especially living in LA, is, you know, you gotta stay positive. You know, there's always a light at the end of the tunnel, and all of this is happening for a reason. I know it sucks to lose people. I know it sucks to not have a car, especially when you've had one since you were 15 and, you know, you become so dependent on your cars. Like, that was literally like my second home and my money maker. So, it's hard. But regardless, that is my life for the past 2 weeks. It can only go up from here, right? Hopefully. But I'm gonna shower. I'm gonna get this off my face because it is dry and crispy. And I'm gonna come back and give you some reviews about it and see what we think. And I'm also gonna take more photos, and I'll put all of those like side by side at the end of the video. All right, see you soon. All right, so I'm back and I'm clean and fresh and moisturized and all sorts of fun stuff. So of course I love the mask. It's one of my faves. The two put together. I've been trying to venture out more and get different masks, but these are the two that I always go to. I will say, like right now, like just right here on the tops of my cheeks feel super rough. I don't know if it's just like the climate change from going from, you know, humid Kentucky back to California, and like, or, you know, doing all of that, traveling. And in all honesty, I don't really take care of my skin like I should. And that's so bad to say, like, as a makeup artist and as someone who knows the importance of good skincare, and I just don't articulate that at all. So maybe that's why, I don't know. And when I was in Kentucky, I did not eat very well, and I did not drink nearly enough water. And so, like, I can definitely tell. One thing I will say, anytime that I do this mask with the two put together, because the exfoliation isn't that great when you just apply it with one of these brushes, I will, when I get in the shower, when I like go to wipe off the mask, I get it wet again to kind of like reactivate it and just massage gently to help exfoliate. As far as these little lip thingies that go, I'm not really sure about them yet. We'll say, I don't feel like I've seen a difference immediately. I wish I had fuller lips, but we'll see. I mean, maybe, like I said, they literally gave me no info on it. Like, doesn't even say like the name of the company on the white part of the packaging to, you know, who it came from. It did come from China, so it's all in Chinese, but it doesn't really even say, like, at least with the Molly Cosmetics, which did come from China as well, it said on there, like, Molly Cosmetics, so you could at least Google that and figure it out, but with this, there's a little bit of nothing. So I will try and go through my emails and like get my order confirmation and everything to be able to put that link down below, because they are fun and they do if nothing else, my lips feel moisturized, which is awesome. So maybe I was just wrong about the collagen aspect and like make them plumper. Maybe it was just like a deep conditioning for your lips. Because I will say, like, as soon as I put this on, I was like, I should have put chapstick on beforehand because my lips were like flaky. And now they're not. So I don't really know. So I'm gonna look up more information since the video's done now. And see if I can give you all more information. I wish I could right now, but I don't know. So if I find the link to this website, I will put that down below, of course. I will put the link of the Aveda products and the Paul Mitchell like toner as well, if you all are interested in those. Yeah. As always, if you love this video, please give it a thumbs up. It makes me so happy to see those. I just love them. If you haven't already, please subscribe to my channel. You can follow me on Snapchat. You can follow me on Facebook, on Instagram, on Twitter. I'm finally trying to get back into the Twitter game. I was never a big fan of it. I'm still like not 100% sold, but I'm trying to be a little bit better, like random thoughts throughout my day and just jot them down on Twitter. So yeah, follow me on all of those. I hope you enjoyed this video. I will see you next week on Monday. And I am going to be reviewing, there's like a fuzzy on my eyelashes. I think for my next video, I am going to review some hair products that I was sent because I told them I was blonde before I went green. So they sent me these products to test out and it's for blonde hair. So I'm gonna be like throughout the week, I'm gonna be kind of bleaching my hair to get the green out so that way I can actually use the products and test them and give you a review about it. And then I will post more about that next week. All right, thanks for watching, guys. I will see you next week. Mwah.